left lung transplant, left sided tracheobronchial tea disruption, and left sided sleeve resection. But here I would like to give you a caveat. Don't try to put a right DLT for the first time when you get these indications. Okay, so if you are doing a decent number of lung isolations, try and do a right sided DLT before left sided surgeries, provided you have a fiber optic bronchoscope. Okay, otherwise go for the safety. So I am telling you one term called margin of safety. So I talked about fiber optic bronchoscope. So how many of you have a fiber optic bronchoscope in your hospital? Okay, that's a good number. So most of the adult patients will have either adult males will have a 39 or 41 size tube, and females will have a 35 and 37. So most of these tubes will take a 3.5 or a 4.2 size fiber optic bronchoscope. But when you are dealing with a smaller Indian patient, like any lady who is less than 152 centimeter may take only 32 DLT. So you may not be able to put a 3.5 bronchoscope, and you may end up putting a 2.8 scope. And 26 and 28, you need definitely need a 2.2 scopes. Okay, so that is one primary prerequisite. Why I am telling you this is, if you look at the history, like when we were students, one of the major worry when you are doing a thoracic surgery was hypoxia during one lung ventilation, and that was especially high when an occasional thoracic anesthetist was anesthetizing. The incidence was about 40 to 50%. But if you look at the current literature, the incidence of hypoxia during one lung ventilation has come down to less than 10%. Now people in the Western world have started talking about the acute lung injury during one lung ventilation, and they are talking less on hypoxia. This is because our understanding of the bronchial anatomy has become better. For those who are not familiar with bronchoscopic anatomy, I refer to Toronto General Hospital's bronchoscopy simulator. That's an excellent free software that will teach you the bronchoscopic anatomy. So next part is margin of safety. What is margin of safety? That is an exam question. By definition, it is the length of the bronchial tree over which the tube can move without occluding the major conducting airway. So if you look at the left DLT, the most proximal acceptable position of a left sided DLT is just distal to the carina. Okay, as you all know, left sided bronchus is about 5 centimeter long. So it can move along this side till this point, after which the tube tip goes beyond the left main bronchus, left upper lobe takeoff, and it won't ventilate the left upper lobe takeoff. So it can move from this point till this point. So the margin of safety is here. On a left side, it's about 16 to 19 millimeter. So that is the reason why people prefer to use a left DLT. When you see the right DLT, it is slightly different. The most proximal acceptable position is the same. The cuff is just distal to the carina, but the most distal acceptable position is when the distal edge of the cuff is at the right upper lobe takeoff. Okay, so let us see the margin of safety. From this point, it can move only up till this. So margin of safety on the right side is about 8 millimeter. Okay, so we need to have a very